do you have any thoughts on more and more scientific studies coming out saying that animal agriculture is actually one of the biggest contributors to climate change and ecological destruction?
Right.
And in terms of policy, do you think there are any suggestions, given that, for example, Health Canada recently updated their food guide, encouraging people to move towards more plant-based diet. So do you have any thoughts on that?
Well, first of all, I found it exciting that we introduced a new food guide. I think that's exactly where we need to be, is that 50% of our food has to be vegetables and fruit. And if you saw, very low protein. And the only protein they showed was actually, it was lentils, it was legumes, and it was like things like salmon, so fish. So I would tell you that I'm on the Environment Committee at the national level. We're very aware about the contribution of animal protein to emissions. And I think that there's a series of recommendations that's going to be coming out of that committee to national government in terms of additional action. Because climate change is happening, we have to take every action possible so that we can save our planet.
Would it be a challenge to redirect subsidies towards plant-based farming and plant protein production and plant-based food away from animal agriculture?
I think that could be part of the solution. I think also part of the solution is educating Canadians about how to eat differently, about how protein actually contributes to these emissions, about the health of legumes, about the fact that we don't need to have as much dairy. So I think part of it's education. I think the food guide is part of it. Can we do more? Absolutely.